was supposed to wait a while before I questioned it. The cable. C-A-B-L-E. A while back, somebody insinuated that they had a way to get into our cable box, which we have from an actual cable company. And we had an actual cable installer come and install our cable. And they told us not to even run cords or junction boxes from one TV to another because it weakens the signal. So after the first year we were here, we ran one or two to the small TVs when Emma was little, so she could, you know, watch Blue's Clues in the living room and still be able to run out to the table in the kitchen and watch it at lunchtime, or if she was coloring, or just to give her some freedom of movement. And we had all the little boxes upstairs and whatnot, but I mostly only used TVs except for the kitchen and the living room. Any other TV we've had in the house, I've just hooked a DVD player or a VCR up to it. You know, sit in bed and watch a movie, or put a movie on in Emma's room while she's playing, you know, one of her cartoons or whatnot. We had a whole different setup, a whole different, oh, that's funny, eh? A whole different PVR in the basement. Granted, it didn't have whatever that is that you get to go back and watch what you missed. But so that'll be all gone. But somebody insinuated here a while back that they can get at your cable. I don't know, I guess the way they get at your computer. And they all get cable for free. And I didn't believe them. But then I started finding out other things like drum kit installed on my... we don't even have drum kit or use it. You walk away from your laptop and you come back and there's like four instances of drum kit installation programs. So somebody's using their drum kit program from my laptop because I had space. But then you're taping programs and somebody must be watching them and erasing them after they watch them, because Chris, from the time you put it there to the time you go to look, hasn't even been home or checked the TV or whatever. It's just too comfortable. So I don't know if they were thinking they'd have one set of cable over here that, you know, everybody in this area could use because somebody knew how to key into it, and another set on the other side of town. I mean, because I know first when we came here, we had a good CD collection and we had sat down and loaded it all up with Winamp, and I manually typed in every song that was on it, and we scanned album covers or went online and found the album covers for the art, and we set up our Winamp so beautifully, and our computer crashed because somebody told me that everybody as far out as out on the other side of the highway were hooking into our computer and downloading our whole song listing, our whole album. All of our albums, all of our songs. I mean, we don't even get to use them because our computer is so slow. I won't put them back on my computer. I won't have them on my phone. I'll go without them unless I take a CD and play it, because I am so disgusted. It cost us $900-something to get back our computer because we had uploaded other personal information on it. Nothing we would be ashamed to have someone you know, decode to get back for us. But because they had caused it to crash. And this is what I heard it was. So if I hear it was that, then it was that.